Hello, everyone. Thanks so much for taking the time to listen to Mary Beth and I. Before we get started, I wanted to spend a couple of minutes to do a round of introductions. So Mary Beth, do you mind going first and I'll follow you?
Yeah, not at all. I'm Mary Beth Chalk. I'm the co-founder and chief commercial officer of Beekeeper AI. And I am a 25-year healthcare veteran with a career that has been focused on creating and commercializing data-driven innovation.
That's great. And I'll introduce myself. I'm Vikas Bhatia, and I'm the head of product for Azure Confidential Computing. And Mary Beth, again, I want to thank you for taking the time to be here, because Beekeeper AI has been such an amazing partner as we've been bringing up this new capability of confidential computing. You know, we certainly believe that it's a game-changing technology that is now becoming commercially viable. So before we really get into it, I'd love to hear a little bit about you, to learn a little bit about Beekeeper AI and the problems that you're looking to solve.
Yeah, thank you. So, you know, the old paradigm in healthcare was give me your data or show the data. And it had just become very difficult, if not impossible, to gain access to the data required for algorithms that were being utilized in healthcare. So after struggling around this data access issue for years and years, including long protracted contracting and approvals for everything from IT and security through to the Institutional Review Board approvals, we just decided there had to be a better way. So we leveraged the Azure Confidential Computing stack and many of the services in Azure to create Escrow AI, which is essentially a software that enables two parties, a data steward and an algorithm owner, to work together in a siteless environment. So we're able to fully protect protected health information and allow it to live where it lives, but allow third parties to sitelessly compute on that data while protecting their intellectual property.
That's awesome. So what kind of use cases are you seeing in healthcare that you work in?
So we're seeing use cases, everything from industry-sponsored research to do AI validation and training, all the way through to AI deployment, AI testing. We're also seeing research, grant-funded research opportunities where researchers are looking for a modern research platform that enables them to do multi-site collaborations. And the list just keeps growing with every conversation. But I'm curious what you're seeing around confidential computing in other industries.
Yeah, so all the use cases that you mentioned in the healthcare space, you know, we are hearing them as well. So it's good to hear, you saying all those use cases. But on the confidential computing side, you know, we have seen a lot of interest from regulated industries such as healthcare, you know, that Beekeeper AI is working on. We see interest from financial services, governments and public sector, insurance, anything that deals with super sensitive, private data that regulators want to make sure doesn't get, in the hands of the wrong people. So some of the use cases that we see are, say, in the financial services, we see use cases around anti-money laundering or fraud prevention. I recently had a CISO from a Fortune, 50 odd company, I guess, tell me that all of their models that they run will be confidential as well, because the kinds of data that these models interact with, the models themselves are IP, so they want to protect the IP. Then, shifting over a little bit to public sector and government, we see a whole bunch of use cases around protecting sensitive populations or protecting critical and strategic workloads by running them in the public cloud, as a data classification vector. And similarly, in insurance and other sort of, verticals, we see a whole bunch of use cases around customers wanting to first protect their sensitive workloads when they run in the public cloud. We say that the public cloud can be better than the private cloud, with confidential computing. And we also see, unique sort of use cases that can only be solved with confidential computing. For example, these clean rooms or data rooms, the multi-party analysis scenarios that previously were hard or even impossible to do. So, Marybeth, I've got a question to you because this is something that I hear constantly from our customers. What are you seeing with respect to data privacy and the regulations that are rapidly evolving around us?
Yeah, so really great question. And we were on a phone call with a Fortune 50 company just yesterday with their legal team, both their IP attorney and then their data security counsel and then their general counsel, all speaking with our HIPAA and GDPR legal advisors. And we're seeing just tremendously exciting opportunities in the area of regulation as it moves forward. And there are a couple of very promising trends. Regarding GDPR, the European Network and Information Security Agency has stated that confidential computing is considered state of the art, which opens up the option for siteless processing of personal information in Europe. And as you know, that is has for a long time been a real core tenet of privacy and security in Europe. But because of the nature of confidential computing and the fact that that data is never seen or ever shared, it does remain confidential. And then because the computing happens in a very secure environment where nothing is ever seen, the GDPR is stating that now it's state of the art. At the same time, in the U.S., we've had a HIPAA legal expert take a look at our platform, Escrow AI, which leverages confidential computing, and we've received a legal opinion that has stated that our platform is in full compliance with all of the stated HIPAA regulations and requirements, and because it is, it allows for computing on PHI. It also allows data stewards to license their data because under the HIPAA regulation, how we are going about computing on data is permissible under the HIPAA regulation. So this is it's just a massive paradigm changer. And we're seeing legal teams say BAAs are no longer necessary. We're having institutional review boards say we're going to waive or exempt patient consent because the patient data is never seen nor ever exposed. So if you think about what this means in addressing these types of regulatory barriers to innovation, we're looking at an acceleration of innovation by as much as 50 to 60%. Over the current timeframes for innovation, and that is significant in time to market.
Yeah, absolutely. And I remember I spoken to a healthcare data scientist and somebody who works also in neurobiology. They told me that there is gobs and gobs of data just sitting there that nobody has has had any access to. But now, yeah, because we have the technical assurances that we can get with confidential computing, they were very excited with, the possibilities that lay ahead of us, right? I think that's sort of what makes it super exciting.
I think for someone who's worked in healthcare her whole career, we've always, if you think about data that falls under a curve, we've always been treating to the average. So it's a one size fits most. And the really tremendous breakthrough opportunities lie in the tails of the data. And so by enabling the computing on the tails, which is typically small data sets with high risk for identifiable information, now through confidential computing, you can get at the tails of the data to know why did a certain patient do incredibly well on a specific treatment and another patient totally fail on that treatment. Mm-hmm. So we've got some very exciting days ahead of us. But, I'm curious about your vision for confidential computing and where you see it heading.
Absolutely. So when we talk about confidential computing, Marybeth, we talk about it as confidential computing evolving to the confidential cloud. So, Microsoft was one of the original co-founders of the Confidential Computing Consortium back in September 2019, which is an industry effort, to accelerate the development of confidential computing and adoption all across the hyperscalers. So we have, other folks such as IBM, Google, Alibaba in there. We've got, the major chip manufacturers, Intel, AMD, NVIDIA in there, ARM64 is in there. And there's a whole bunch of, you know, other sort of, you know, companies such as yourself, like, you know, who are also participating in this. So our vision here, Mike Beth, is we want to transform the Azure cloud to the Azure confidential cloud. So whatever you do on Azure today, you know, in the very near future, it'll be something that you operate in a confidential environment. And the way we think about this shift is, you know, just as the world moved from HTTP to HTTPS, all they had to do was add an S at the end of their HTTP, and suddenly they were secure for data in transit. We look at the world evolving in a similar way, where the industry moves from computing in the clear to computing confidentially, almost transparently. And because we now have these capabilities that are, you know, ready for scale and, you know, ready for customers to bring their really, you know, intense workloads to run on, you know, we are super excited with, you know, what's ahead of us. Now, don't get me wrong. I don't think we are all the way there. You know, this technology still needs to mature and, you know, get battle tested. But from our vision perspective, this is certainly where, you know, we think we are going. And, you know, as part of the OC3 conference panel that the Azure CTO, Mark Rasinovich, was part of, we also had other CTOs like the Intel, AMD, and NVIDIA, you know, leaders participating in that discussion as well. So this is clearly an industry effort underway where, you know, I'm certainly passionate about being a part of this. Privacy is core to how I think about the world. And, you know, this is certainly something that we feel game changing is a word that gets used a lot and gets thrown around a lot. And I heard you also mention it as you were talking passionately about what this could do to healthcare data. So I think we are all sort of excited with the possibilities ahead, but I think this is certainly something that the industry will do together as we further, you know, the adoption of these data privacy enhancing technologies that lie ahead of us. So this has been great, Maribeth. Thank you so much for taking the time. Any closing thoughts for folks on the call before we wrap up?
No additional thoughts other than thank you for your leadership and your vision at Microsoft. We're so grateful for the Azure environment in which Escrow AI is possible.
Well, thank you very much for saying that. And I also want to thank you, Maribeth, and your entire team for being phenomenal partners in bringing something like this to the industry and, you know, making the world a better place. So, well, that's all, folks. Thank you so much for the time, for listening to us, to Maribeth and I. We hope you enjoyed it. And please check out our website, you know, https://aka.ms/AzureCC, which is the starting point. Maribeth, what's the Beekeeper AI URL?
It is beekeeperai.com.
Perfect. So thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.